The Xbox Adaptive Controller is a device from Microsoft which is designed for gamers with limited mobility to make gaming more accessible. While the Xbox Adaptive Controller does have other accessibility features, in this video we're going to be looking at some of the switches we use here at SpecialEffect and how to use them in the Adaptive Controller. Here at SpecialEffect we use a range of different switches for the people that we work with. The type of switch that we use depends entirely on the amount or type of functional movement that the individual has. The ultralight switch is a small, lightweight switch. It requires very little pressure to activate and provides audible and tactile feedback when the switch is being pressed. We use these with people who have very small movements or limited strength. They are great for mounting on controllers or in small spaces where people might have tiny movements. The buddy button is a larger switch and is great for people who do not have limited strength and like to use large movements to hit it, such as with their hands, their feet or their head. The spec switch is a little bit smaller than the buddy button, but it requires the same amount of pressure to activate it. This switch is a very lightweight lever-style switch and only takes 2 grams of pressure to activate. We use these with people who have very limited strength or very small movements. Any accessibility switch with a 3.5mm jack should work in the Xbox Adaptive Controller. Here are some examples of other switches that we use at SpecialEffect. The Xbox Adaptive Controller has switch ports for every button on a standard Xbox controller. The switch sockets are all situated on the back of the device and are all clearly labelled. The X1 and X2 sockets are up on left stick and down on left stick as default. However, these and any of the sockets can be remapped to any button on the controller. This includes joystick directions for left and right analog stick.
This means you can use a warp forward switch for first person games if you can only access one joystick.
The Xbox Adaptive Controller has 2 large black buttons on the front of it. These are mapped to A and B as default, however they can be remapped to any button on the controller. You remap your switches on the Xbox One itself or on a PC. You can save different controller profiles which you can switch between using the profile button. The switches can be used alongside a standard Xbox One controller using co-pilot settings. Or it can be used as a standalone device. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions about switches or the Xbox Adaptive Controller, please do get in touch with us. Thank you.